I'm shooting my first ever Get Ready With Me video, and this is actually the third time I'm doing it. The first two, I experimented one in my actual bathroom, one in the bathroom of the hotel we were staying in, and the lighting was just, I think this is perfect. So let's start. I usually begin by taking a face towel and then dampening one small part to exfoliate my lips.
Hello, pimple!
When I exfoliate my lips, I usually take a cotton pad, put a bit of coconut oil on it, and then rub it on my lips, and then get a lip scrub and exfoliate toner. The Kiehl's Ultra Facial Toner. I use the Ultra Facial line, and I have been for years.
Would you like to say hi to my Captain America headband?
Then we'll have that set a bit on the face. And then I get this hyaluronic acid with vitamin C, also from Kiehl's. I just take a pump of that. Just one pump. And then I get my Ultra Facial Cream, which has the SPF 30, because sunscreen is important. Glossier Bubble Wrap, which is a plumping cream. I use it on both my eyes and lips. Okay, now we go with the brows. I used to have the translucent powder from Laura Mercier, but I've run out. So whatever is left on this brush, I use that. And it's just to prep my brow area. I don't want it too shiny. This is actually my biggest insecurity, my brows.
See, I have hair. It's just pretty sparse.
I used to have really thick brows, but then I plucked them really thin and they just rebelled on me. So when I went to Japan 2 years ago, I hoarded on brow stuff, mostly from K Palette and another brand I forgot. But now I've run out, so the pencil is done, but I still use the powder on this pencil. And it's just a good way to put more color in there. Okay, that's a pretty good base. I feel so naked without my smoky eyes. This is a pencil that I recently got from Maybelline. It's really cheap, but it's also really good. Okay, I think that's pretty good. And then I get the brush from the K Palette. Make sure that it is evenly distributed, the color, so it looks feathery. Then I go over my sparse areas. And then I get whatever is left of my eyebrow from Glossier.
And just brush over the hairs.
I love this product so much. I've hoarded and now I've also run out. I have to restock on that soon. Okay, so for the eyes, I use my Shiseido eyelash curler. I've used Shuyumura and the other one from the brand behind Fiberwick. I use the eyelash curler. Also Charlotte Tilbury. But nothing worked as much as Shiseido's. I think it's because it just goes with my eye shape. Eyebrow, pen, brush, and just make sure that the hairs are separated, nicely separated. I usually tight line with only dark brown eye pencil, but for more depth to my eyes, I added black, which will be applied on the inner corners of my upper and lower lash line, and then brown is on the outer. Now we use the brown on the outer part. Okay, so we smudge that. Just make it less harsh. You can also use a Q-tip, but the thing about Q-tips is that sometimes it just takes away the product instead of spreading. So for the eyeshadow, I use the Teviot palette, Hearts Edition, and I take the shade Milano, and I just apply that there. There are no tips for this part. I don't really have tips, and I
just work according to my eye shape and years of practice of what works. So I don't really follow any tips, and it's hard because I have monolids, you know, hooded eyes. I do like to show my little bags some love because when I squint, they appear and I put makeup there. So you blend, blend, blend. And then I take the shade Soa and just repeat the same steps until you're completely satisfied with how the color looks on your eyes. And then I just tight line one more time. And because of my Asian lashes, I can't not use a primer. Can never curl it enough. So as you know, or not yet, but now you will, I have stopped using foundation in 2014, late 2014, early 2015. And I've not looked back since. I feel like my skin could breathe more, and you know, I don't have to worry about looking cakey, or you know, when hugging someone and my face sticks to their shoulder and oh no, there's makeup on your shirt. Occasionally, I do like to use a concealer, only on days when I feel like I should, and today is one of those days. I also don't use a beauty blender. I use fingers, Nature's Beauty Blender. My acne scars. I think we're good. So I've been using Nars since I was in college. It was the first makeup brand I actually really invested on. And RB Chanko at the time, who was working at the MAC counter over in Glorieta, asked me, what was your first ever lipstick? And I was, take note, I was 15 years old at this point. And I said, Nars. And she's like, oh my god, I love it. And then she gave me more samples from MAC. I think she liked that I was like such a kikai at 15. Anyway, so I used to use orgasm. Don't take out a word from that sentence. But now I've shifted to Amour because I love how it looks on my skin even when I'm tan. I do have an Hourglass highlight palette, but recently I've been using one of the shades from this Dolce Vita palette from Charlotte Tilbury, which is also one of my obviously go-to Smokey-Eye palettes. But I use that. It reminds me of Champagne Pop from Becca. As a base, I use Sunny's Lip Dip in Peachy Kinda. And then I use my fingers to evenly spread that out. And then I dab that. Dab. Sorry. And then I top it off with MAC's Runway Hit. Then I take, this is, I think, Hearts of Flame from MAC. And I put that on the inner parts of my lip. And for that to pop more, I know, I use Pat McGrath in Christie, my favorite. Look, it's almost finished. Mascara time. And we're done. Oh, wait, hair. I recently did a video on how I do my hair, but I made a recent discovery. Super Milk from Lush. Oh my god. This is the only product I use on my hair now. And it smells amazing. I know I say this about a lot of products, but this does. Fork is obsessed with this hair, man. I'm running out. So I hope you enjoyed this Get Ready With Me video. This is my first ever Get Ready With Me video. Third time I'm actually shooting it, but I hope you enjoyed getting ready with me. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.